I would now like to invite our guest of honor, respected Professor Aggarwal, to say a few words.
Dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, Professor, Vice Chancellor, Dr. Sharat Chandra, and various other colleagues, I'm very, very, very delighted to be here. I want to thank all of you for giving me this opportunity to come here and share some of my thoughts with you. As all of you know, that my name is Bharat, and I want to contribute something to Bharat, and that's the goal of my life. And for some of you who may not know, in life there is something called serendipity. Serendipity means things happen in life, we don't know why they happen and how they happen. But as long as your heart is at the right place, things do happen and things do go the right way. And I would like to share some of that experience with you, because I come from a very small little town called Batala, which is in 20 kilometers from the Bagha border. And my parents migrated from what is today called Pakistan in 1947. And I was the first product of independent India, and I say that's why my parents named me as Bharat. So it just so happened we had only one college in our town called Bering Union Christian College. So I happened to go to that college, and the highest that college could offer me was a pre-medical. So I finished my pre-medical over there, and that was the end of Batala, because I could not go any further. And next thing you know, my brother put me on a train to Delhi and said goodbye. And that was the year 1968 was the year that he said goodbye, put me on the train, now you are at your own. And it just so happened that the Chief Minister of Maharashtra came to Batala to give me an award for being number one in chemistry as a part of the pre-medical student. So I received the award, I ended up in Delhi, and there I was in Delhi University, and I ended up doing my bachelor degree. Because the only way to advance is to study, study, study. Study as much as you can. So I ended up in Delhi University, Hansraj College, and thereafter I ended up in Banaras Hindu University as a master's student. And I finished my master's, I was doing my PhD under Dr. Kanungo, and I happened to have a dirty habit of reading newspaper. And I've been reading newspaper my whole life, and I was reading newspaper. All of a sudden I saw ad in the newspaper which said from the Ministry of Education that scholarship to study abroad, that anybody can interested can apply for it. And I happened to apply it, and I got the scholarship, which I could not believe. I went for an interview in the Ministry of Education in Delhi, and 2 months later I got the scholarship. And my professor, Dr. Madhusudan Kanungo, came in my office in the Dalmia Hostel, And Dr. Pardeshi Lal knows that hostel very well. And Dr. Kanungo told me, you should not go to America. I said, why not? Said, look, you finish your PhD, finish everything over here, then you should go to America. I said, no, I want to go right now. So I ended up in America. There I was in the University of California, Berkeley, that some of you may have heard of. And that is where I got my doctorate. And then I came back to India looking for a job. And I met this guy, G.P. Talwar. He was a professor and head of the department at All India Institute of Medical Sciences. And I asked him that, okay, now I have a doctorate degree, can I get a job here? He said, no, you cannot. I said, why not? He said, we have too many people in India, and we have to find a way to control the population. And if you can find the solution, we got the cure how to control the population. And you go figure it out, how to control the population of India. I said, how do you do that? He said, very easy. So I said, is it? He said, yes. So he said, there is a hormone that is produced in the women who are pregnant. Okay, and that's what leads to pregnancy. And that hormone, if you can isolate that hormone, we can make a vaccine and we got the, you know, control the population of India. Okay, so how do you do that? He said, don't worry, I will set you up in a place called University of California, San Francisco. And there is a laboratory called Hormone Research Lab. And they've been isolating hormone their whole life. So the grinding up the brain and grinding up every organ in the body and isolating hormones. So I said, okay, but I need the money to go back and isolate this hormone. He said, don't worry about that too either. There is something called Population Council, which is a part of the Rockefeller University, and I can set you up with them and they will provide you the scholarship, you know, for that. So he did that. He came through. So he came through both with the scholarship and he sent me back to University of California, San Francisco. And I worked there on isolation of the hormone. And I was the first one to isolate that hormone. And then I came back to India, and all of you may have heard of, there is one called equine chorionic gonadotropin, another one human chorionic gonadotropin, HCG. So I was the first one to isolate, and then I went back to India, and when I went back the first time, it was Indira Gandhi in power. And I even met Indira Gandhi at that time. When I went the second time, he said, look, we cannot offer you a job. Why? Now we have Morarji Desai in power. And he believes in urine therapy. He does not believe anything in control of pregnancy. What do I do? So apparently it just so happened that he said, look, you can come back as a pool officer. Pool officer, what I call it, a fool officer. That you come back, they give you 1,000 rupees as unemployment allowance and you look for a job. So I said, no, I don't want to do that. So I went back to America. And there I ran into two guys. Both came from Harvard. And one who had graduated, other who did not. They both came to San Francisco. The one who graduated started the first gene-based company. The first one, called Genentech. And the guy who did not graduate started Apple. That Steve Jobs that you might have heard of. And the guy who started a gene-based company called Bob Swanson. So the first Apple that Steve Jobs made, he brought it to us because you know Bob Swanson was his closest friend. So, you know, so we have been Apple ever since. And within a week after I joined Genentech, this guy Bob Swanson walks in my office, said, Bart, BART. BART in San Francisco means Bay Area Rapid Transit. They could not say Bharat. So BART, I want you to find a cure to cancer. Hey, wait a minute. I don't know anything about cancer. So he said, I don't know anything either, but there is a something called immune system. And immune system kills only cancer guy and not the normal guy. And if you can figure it out, how it does that, we got the cure. And so I started to work on my taking everybody's blood, anybody, and there were only 10, 15 people in the whole company. And so we started taking everybody's blood, collecting enough blood to isolate that factor that will kill the cancer guy and not the normal guy. And this is how we ended up isolating a factor. We named it tumor necrosis factor. And as you know, that blood has two kind of cells, lymphocytes and monocytes. So the question is, where are this factor coming from? And then we fractionated. We found that it was coming from monocytes. Then we started isolating the lymphocytes, and we ended up isolating another factor. We did not know what to call it. So my colleague who had came up with interferon, you might have heard of interferon, interferon alpha, beta, gamma. So he said, start the series TNF alpha, beta, gamma. So this is how we came up with this. Now we had identified. And I'm going to tell you in my lecture that when it comes to test tube, everything works. When it comes to animals, most of the things work. But when it comes to humans, you will be lucky even if 1% of the things work. So to determine that if TNF is truly an anti-cancer agent, we have to test it in the patients. So I ended up in the biggest cancer center in the world called University of Texas MD Anderson Cancer Center in Houston. And that's where we injected our TNF. We did the clinical trials and injected TNF. All the patients responded, but they got more sick than ever before. Should it be called tumor necrosis factor or tumor promoting factor? So as of today, TNF blocker have been approved by the FDA with a market over $50 billion a year. No drug known to man has a bigger market. You can imagine. And that is where we discovered all those are just nothing but antibodies, which means they have to be injected. But we were looking for orally bioavailable TNF blocker. And that is where I had a technician, Raj Pandita, that who brought turmeric, haldi, whole turmeric from her kitchen, and we tested it. It worked remarkably well. And this is how we identify the active compound from turmeric called curcumin as a TNF blocker. So even as of today, it works in the test tube, it works in animal, it works in humans. Yet it has a close to zero market. Why? Because nobody can make money out of haldi, out of turmeric. It is available anywhere and everywhere. And people are trying to make all kind of manipulation. They are trying to make all kind of permutation combinations, trying to make money out of curcumin or turmeric. So, to make a long story short, now we have identified over 100 different compounds from the mother nature. And I'm going to tell you in all my lectures that mother is the one bringing us in this world, and mother nature is there to take care of it. And that's what my whole talk is going to be. And so if I look back, what happened, when it happened, how it happened, it is all serendipity. So our life is full of serendipity. If your heart is at the right place, things will happen, and there's no question about that. With that, I stop right here and thank all of you for giving me this opportunity to be here. Thank you.